had his personal life. But in if I had his personal private business, he just told me I shouldn't talk to you because you're not as nice as I think you are. And he did say that, you know, a husband had had an affair with some woman and she wasn't pleased with him, but and it upset him. But he was showing me that the woman was advanced into all kind of tricks and stuff in the bed. And that's not normal. So he shouldn't be hurt by the rejection of him. But I've been calling, like I said, went to a doctor in Atlanta, and this doctor, she was telling me that she worked her way through college as a prostitute. It was the blonde doctor. And it was just a mess, but I guess life in the big city, you know what I'm saying? And then with the encounter with the roommate next door, when she had the man screaming for a whole lot, silent. Enough of a scream the whole time. So I'm just assuming, you know, I don't know what the bitch doing, but I'm assuming that the bitch know how to find anything and such tricks in the bed. You know what I'm saying? I'm just assuming that that's the bitch know how to find all such tricks in the bed. You know what I'm saying? But I don't concern myself with other people in my life. But no, the Lord tries to tell me, first I'm being there. Just trying to see in all of us that what they have showed me about tomorrow. She showed me that she thinks it's funny that there's somebody watching me talk to her. And it's sad. There's two people specifically he's saying watching me talk to her. And one is asking to use it as an entertainment call. She had said she would be in the movie if they used it that way. And the other one is asking to talk to her personally by saying they look better than her. And then she think that shit funny how they standing up trying to get to know her, waiting for me to talk to her. And all they say is they look better than her. But she's telling them she not flat about it. I guess I don't know what they asking for, or who, I don't know who it is either. But I can see them telling her that, I don't know what exactly they're telling her, but they're saying something sexual about me. I can see it like this. They're saying something sexual with that dick like that to her while I'm talking. And then they try to come in the conversation. But she's asking them to come another way if they want to meet her. But they won't do it because she don't want them. But this way flattering her. But she not taking it. She not taking it flat. But she's trying to have a little bit of integrity. But a lot of women are taking it. A lot of them like to laugh. They show me a lot of white women like to laugh when he do that. But he's trying to follow me because he don't want to educate himself. He want to see who he want to meet. Now, I don't bite my tongue when I meet people. You know what I'm saying? Even if they don't want to meet. But I don't know why he's so afraid of me. I guess I'm saying what was gonna do that, should be afraid of me. But he's not really saying that's gonna speak about your personal life in itself. He did say that the money that you have is your husband had. And he did say, you can get mad if you want to say that. But I'm sorry that he's angry about something. I don't know what. Maybe y'all can work it out. I don't know. And they can put his anger on the table, the issue that he ain't gonna come on the table. And it also showing that being in the bed, I know this would make you mad, but the same thing I'm trying to forget. The job of having limited sexual ideas. shit nigga men do to their mind. When the shit get good to you, you start thinking that everybody wanna do. And you don't like that shit about them. When the shit get good to you in the bed, you can see them like everybody wanna do. And you don't like that shit about them. And that's what you're saying, that's the shit nigga men do. Like everybody wanna take it. But as far as that, I'm not really telling that he did say, I don't want to say too much that he said something because I'm not trying to, you know, get hurt in the mind. No one's telling me the daughters need help that study happens. That's what he was telling me. He starts telling me that your daughter got second thoughts about going to that college. You said they need help that study happens. But I mean, if you ask me, you didn't ask me. You all have rights. I would just, don't give me a roll white school mom. You can't tell me that I would be living off and let my money work for me. Rather than worrying about it. I mean, if I had those kind of needs, I would just go, those kind of attack. Like say, let's just say that my pet project moving make me $750 million. I said, I have to do nothing ever again. I have to do like no other movie ever fucking again. Never again. That's what I'm saying to you. Since y'all had all kind of looks that you can go on, that you always can, I would just go try to get a role on whatever movie, you know, and get that money and let it work for me. That's what I would do. But I'm not trying to get up in your business. I'm seeing this attack. I'm seeing it. And what's making me angry about it is, I told God, I'm like, and it's not your business. I'm just trying to come to you because you was wondering what I know about you. I don't know nothing about you. I know that he had been verbal abuse. I don't know if he stopped or not. He had been verbal abuse to you. But, in our human capacity, if I confront somebody, I will kill them or they'll kill me. You see what I'm saying? Somebody's doing that with their dick while I'm talking. If I confront them, they'll kill me or I'll kill them. And that's the way I see that. I don't need him to go into all of this shit about the white people this, and the white people that, and the black male this, and the black. If you're gonna do that, you need to fucking wait. You need to move quickly with it, or you need to wait. Because I didn't come to you. You came to me with the message of salvation. You came to me with the message of salvation. And that's exactly how I feel about it. That's how I feel about it. Otherwise, I'm left with my humanity to deal with my problems. Now, I'm very angry right now. But I want you to know God is not telling me your business. Nothing that's going on in your home. I know it sounds like I talk too much, or he told me too much, but he had showed me that I was bothering you. And when I said all that bullshit to you, I was saying something that didn't know that you and your family didn't think that shit was funny. Because you were already dealing with some things, and that was what you were dealing with. You were already dealing with, and that was what you didn't think that shit, I thought it was funny. But to tell you that I'm your girlfriend from jail and say I'm gonna do all kind of shit to you and we married and stuff, all that shit was fine. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. But anyway, I told the Lord, I say, if you can make my mistake in your life, send you comfort and relief and fix my mistake in bothering you, then I would ask that. And I would ask that, I apologize to you for that. I hope that everything is going well for you all.